Hello friends, welcome to the session on Operational Amplifier. In this session, we'll be discussing about how to use Operational Amplifier as a differentiator. In this session, we will see what is the circuit diagram for Operational Amplifier as a differentiator, and we will also obtain the expression for the output voltage of differentiator. Friends, as you know that you are viewing this session on my YouTube channel, Learn with Prakash Kanade. And do subscribe to the channel to see many more videos on the subjects of electronics and computer science. So let us start the session with the question, what we mean by differentiator. Differentiator is an electronic circuit which can perform the mathematical operation of differentiation. That is, the output voltage of this circuit is equal to the derivative of the input voltage. We know that operational amplifier is a very versatile circuit and that can be used to build many more applications. We have seen that the operational amplifier can be used to build adder, subtractor, and integrator. And it is also possible that we can construct the circuit of differentiator by using operational amplifier. Differentiator is an electronic circuit which differentiates the input voltage. That is, the output voltage of the differentiator is proportional to the derivative of the input voltage. When the triangular wave input is applied to the differentiator circuit, then at the output, we will get a square wave output. Differentiator circuit is a very popular circuit and it is used in analog computers. And as I told you that nowadays digital computers are more popular, but analog computers are sometimes preferred over the digital one because of their real-time response. Differentiator circuit can also be used as a wave shaping circuit. So whenever you want to convert the input wave into another form, then that circuit is being called as a wave shaping circuit. So the circuits of integrator and differentiator can also be used as the wave shaping circuits. Differentiator circuit can also be used to convert the analog signal into digital form. So A to D converter can also be constructed by using the differentiator circuit. This circuit can also be used as a high pass filter circuit in audio applications. So whenever you want to process any audio signal, then those circuits can consist of the differentiator circuit as a high pass filter circuit. Differentiator circuit can also be used in control systems in various industries. So now let us go for the circuit diagram of differentiator by using operational amplifier. As shown in this circuit diagram, observe that the non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier is grounded and the input voltage is applied to the inverting input through the input capacitor. So observe that normally we make the use of the input resistance, but in this circuit, instead of making the use of the resistance, we have used a capacitor at the input. A feedback resistance RF is connected between the output and the inverting input. Input voltage Vin is applied to the inverting input through the capacitor C1. As shown in the figure, the feedback resistance RF is connected between the output and the inverting input. Non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier is grounded, and therefore you can say that this circuit is in the inverting mode. For the purpose of the analysis, we will suppose that the voltage at the inverting input is V minus and the voltage at non-inverting input is V plus. And we will also suppose that the current that is flowing through the resistance RF is IF and the current that is flowing through the capacitor is IC. Input voltage is being amplified by the operational amplifier and the part of the output is coupled back to the inverting input through the resistance RF. This kind of the feedback that is being used in the differentiator circuit is a negative feedback. And therefore this circuit can be called as a closed loop circuit. The gain of the operational amplifier can be adjusted by adjusting the values of the external components such as RF and C1. Now we can easily prove that the output voltage of this circuit is proportional to the differentiation of the input voltage. To prove this, we need to analyze the circuit. And we know that whenever we want to analyze the operational amplifier circuit, it is possible that in three steps, we can analyze the circuit. So the expression for the differentiator can be obtained in the three steps. In the first step, we will write the Kirchhoff's equation for the non-inverting input of the operational amplifier. We know that the non-inverting input of the operational amplifier is grounded, and therefore we can write the Kirchhoff's equation V plus is equal to zero. Similarly, we can write the Kirchhoff's equation at inverting input of the operational amplifier. At inverting input, you can easily observe that there are two currents meeting, IC and IF, and therefore we can write the Kirchhoff's equation IC plus IF or I1 is equal to zero. Observe that this base current, bias current IB2 is equal to zero. Now we can substitute the values of IC and IF or I1. We know that the current flowing through the capacitor can be given as the capacitance multiplied by dt of voltage across the capacitor. The voltage across the capacitor is V in minus V minus, and therefore the current IC can be written as C1 into d/dt of V in minus V minus, and the current that is flowing through the resistance RF can be given as VO minus V minus divided by RF. In the third step, we will make the voltage at inverting input and the voltage at non-inverting input equal to zero. We know that both the voltages are same, and non-inverting terminal of the operational amplifier is grounded, and therefore V plus is equal to V minus is equal to zero. So we can rewrite the above equation as C1 into d/dt of V in is equal to minus VO divided by RF. And therefore we can get the expression for the output voltage VO is equal to minus RF into C1 into d/dt of V1, V in. That is, observe that the output voltage is proportional to the derivative of the input voltage. Our output voltage is minus RF into C1 times the derivative of the input voltage. So this proves that this circuit works as a differentiator. To the differentiator circuit, we can apply the different form of signals. Say, for example, if we apply square wave at the input to the differentiator, then at the output of the differentiator, we will get the spikes. If we apply a triangular wave at the input to the differentiator, then at the output, we will get the rectangular wave. If you apply a sine wave to the input of the differentiator, then at the output, we will get a cosine wave. Thank you, friends, for viewing the session. Hopefully you have understood how the operational amplifier can be used as a differentiator. Thank you all for viewing the session.